Hello student, as you know, we are facing a critical problem all over India due to COVID-19 outbreak. So we have to be smart, stay at home and don't go outside. So our school, Howard Public School, in association with Assam Jobs Club, are organizing online classes for class 9 and 10, especially for two subjects, maths and science. So we are discussing one by one the chapter of the maths and science, and today we are going to discuss about the introduction of trigonometry. Now, as you know, trigonometry, what do you mean by trigonometry? Trigonometry is based on right angle triangle. Based on right angle triangle. So suppose A, B, C is a right angle triangle. Here angle B is your 90 degree. So angle A and angle C must be less than 90 degree. That means these two angles must be equiangle. Why? Because we know the summation of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So if angle B is 90 degree, so the summation of the other two angles must be 90 degree. That means the two angle A and C must be less than 90 degree. That's why the angle A and C are equiangle. What do you mean by equiangle now? Equiangle are those angles whose value is less than 90 degree. Obtuse angle are those angles whose value is greater than 90 degree. Now see, here, now we have to study about the trigonometric ratio. Trigonometric ratio. Now, what do you mean by trigonometric ratio? What do you mean by trigonometric ratio? Trigonometric ratio are like this sine. Suppose this is angle A, this is angle B. So for angle A, we have to study about sine A, then cos A, then your tan A, etc. So for angle C, it will be sin C, then cos C, then tan C, then the opposite of sin is your cosec A, opposite of cos is your cos A will be your sec A, and opposite of tan will be your cot A. So you have to study all the things. Now see, for the angle A, listen carefully, for the angle A, this is angle B, so it is a right angle triangle, and for the angle A, this side BC will be perpendicular. This will be your base for the angle A, okay, and this will be your, the side opposite to 90 degree is always known as hypotenuse. Okay, so what I am saying that for the angle A, the side which is opposite to the angle, the side which is opposite to the angle is known as the perpendicular. This angle, this side will be base, and the side opposite to the 90 degree is your hypotenuse. For the angle A, this will be AB will be base, BC will be perpendicular, AC will be hypotenuse. But suppose, again, we draw one triangle ABC where B is 90 degree. Now we have to take all the trigonometric ratio with respect to angle C. Now see, for the angle C, that I have told you that the side opposite to the angle will be your perpendicular. The side opposite to 90 degree is your hypotenuse, and the other side will be your base. So for the angle C, AB is your perpendicular. For the angle C, AB is perpendicular, BC is your base, and AC will be your hypotenuse. Now see the differences between angle for angle A and angle for angle C. I am repeatedly saying that suppose you are asked to find the trigonometric ratio for the angle A. So thus remember that for the angle A, the side opposite to angle A. Now see, for in this triangle, the side opposite to angle A is BC. So always remember that the side opposite to the angle is always the perpendicular. The side opposite to 90 degree is always hypotenuse, and the other side will be base. So for the angle A, your AB will be base. Now see, BC is the side opposite to angle A. So BC will be your perpendicular, and the side AC is the side which is opposite to angle B, which is 90 degree. So AC will be your hypotenuse. Now see, the hypotenuse will be remain constant. Here also AC is the hypotenuse, here also AC is the hypotenuse. So here for angle C, the opposite side is AB. That's why AB will be your perpendicular, BC will be your base, and AC will be your hypotenuse. Up to this clear? Okay. Now see. Now we are going to study about trigonometric ratio. Okay. Now first let me draw one triangle. Suppose this is right angle triangle. So suppose this is right angle triangle. This is A, this is D, this is C. Now, suppose we are now going to find the trigonometric ratio for the angle A. Now, for the angle A, tell me which one will be your perpendicular? Yes, BC will be your perpendicular, AC will be your, because BC is opposite to A, so BC will be perpendicular. Then side AC is opposite to B, so AC will be your hypotenuse. And AB will be your base. Now see, now what is trigonometric ratio? Sine. Suppose we are going to find the trigonometric ratio for the angle A, a sine A. Always remember, sine is the ratio of perpendicular by hypotenuse. Now here, what is the perpendicular for this triangle? For the in this triangle ABC, in this right angle triangle ABC, for angle A, which one will be your perpendicular? Yes, good. BC will be your perpendicular. Which one will be your hypotenuse? AC will be your hypotenuse. So here, sine A will be BC by AC. Again, cos A. Now, always remember this, cos is the ratio of base by hypotenuse. Now in this triangle ABC, which one is your base? See here, AB is the base, so AB, and which one is your hypotenuse? AC is the hypotenuse, so AC. So here cos A will be your AC. Now, 10A, 10 means the ratio of perpendicular by base. Now here, what is the perpendicular? BC, which is the base? AB. Okay, now we have found sine A perpendicular by hypotenuse, so BC by AC. Perpendicular by hypotenuse, so BC BC by AC. Cos is base by hypotenuse, the base is AB and hypotenuse is AC. So this cos A. Then tan A is your perpendicular by base. Here base is your perpendicular is your BC and base is your AB. So BC by AB. Now see the opposite of sine. Always remember the opposite of sine is your what? Cosec. The opposite of sine is your cosec. The opposite of sine is your cosec. Now see here. So sine, opposite of sine is your cosec. Cosec. Opposite means what? The ratio will be hypotenuse by perpendicular. Hypotenuse by perpendicular. Now what is your hypotenuse here? Your hypotenuse here AC, just opposite. So it will be AC by BC. Then opposite of cos A is your sec A. Opposite of cos A is your sec A. So the ratio will be, here the cos A is the ratio of base and hypotenuse. So sec A will be hypotenuse by base. So hypotenuse by base. So hypotenuse will be your AC, your base will be your what? Base will be your AB. So just reverse it, AC by AB. And the opposite of tan is your cot. So cot A. So cot A is the ratio of opposite. So it will be base by perpendicular. So your base is your what? Base is your AB and perpendicular is your BC. So AB by BC. So we found sine A equal to BC by AC for angle A. So the opposite will be cosec A, AC by BC. Cos A is your base by hypotenuse, that means AB by AC. So cos the reverse, the opposite of cos will be sec A. So it will be hypotenuse by base. That's why AC by AB here. Look at here, AC by AB. Now tan A is your perpendicular by base. That means BC by AB. So opposite will be your cot A. So cot A will be base by perpendicular. Now see, base is your AB and perpendicular is your BC. So we have found sin A equal to BC by AC, cos A equal to AB by AC, tan A equal to BC by AB, cosec A equal to the reverse of sin A, AC by BC, sec A will be the reverse of cos A, AC by AB, and tan A will be the reverse, so cot A will be the, sorry, cot A will be the reverse of tan A, so AB by BC. We have found the trigonometric ratio sin A, cos A, yes or no, cosec A, sec A, cot A, all for the angle A. Now we are going to find the trigonometric ratio for the angle C, okay, for the angle C. Now see here. Draw angle C. Let me draw another triangle. Another right angle triangle. Okay. Wait, let me draw from here. Let me draw from here. Then it will be easy for you to understand the purpose. Okay. So this is the triangle. Now see, this is the triangle, this is the angle B, this is the angle A, sorry, this is, let's take this one as angle A and this one as angle C. Now we are going to find the trigonometric ratio for the angle C, for the angle C. Now see, for the angle C, I have told earlier that the base and the perpendicular will be sensed according to the what? Angle. Now for the angle C, which one will be your perpendicular? For the angle C, which one perpendicular? Yes. For the angle C, your AB will be your perpendicular. If for the angle A, BC is perpendicular. For the angle A, your BC is perpendicular. Why? Because BC is opposite to A. But we are going to find the trigonometric ratio for the angle C. And the for the angle C, the opposite side is your AB. So AB will be your perpendicular. Then AB will be perpendicular. Then the side opposite to right angle triangle is always hypotenuse. So a hypotenuse will remain same. The hypotenuse will remain same. It does not depend on these two angles. Why? Because for this triangle ABC, the right angle will be only one, this is B. So the side opposite to angle B is AC. So AC will be your hypotenuse. And the other side will be, so here AB is perpendicular, AC is your hypotenuse, and other side will be what? Will be your base. Now, we have to find the trigonometric ratio sine C. Then, cos C. Then, tan C. And opposite will be sine, what will be the opposite of sine? Yes, it will be cosec C. What is the opposite of cos? It will be sec C. What is the opposite of tan? It will be cot C. All of you, see the NCERT, all of you have NCERT book and see the page number 175. Okay. See the page number 175 of NCERT maths book. See the page number 175. Now see, we are going to find the trigonometric here in your book, they are finding that trigonometric ratio for the angle A. But in exam, you may ask to find the trigonometric ratio for angle C. Now see, what is the sine formula? That means ratio. What is the sine? What is the ratio? The sine is the ratio of your perpendicular by hypotenuse. That means perpendicular by hypotenuse. Yes or no? Perpendicular by hypotenuse. So here perpendicular is your, which one is perpendicular here? Perpendicular is your AB and C, this one. Perpendicular is AB and hypotenuse will be AC. For cos C, the ratio is base by hypotenuse. So which one is base here? Yes. BC is base here. So BC by AC. Tan will be perpendicular by base. Tan is the ratio of perpendicular by base. So which one is perpendicular? Tell me AB. Yes, AB is the perpendicular and BC will be your base. Now, sine cosec C is the reverse of which one? Sine C. Cosec C is the reverse of sine C. So, cosec C will be hypotenuse by perpendicular. So, your hypotenuse is what? AC. That means AC by AB. Sec C is the opposite of cos C. Sec C is the opposite of cos C. Yes or no? Sec C is the opposite of cos C. So it will be hypotenuse by base. So your hypotenuse will be AC. Base will be your BC. Cot C is the opposite of tan C. That means base by perpendicular. So your base will be your BC. And perpendicular will be your AB. Okay, got this? So we have learned how to find the trigonometric ratio. Yes or no? Sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot for any angle. So তো ইয়ার সাইন সি ইজ ইয়োর এবি বাই এসি পারপেন্ডিকুলার বাই হাইপোটেনাস, পারপেন্ডিকুলার বাই হাইপোটেনাস। দেন ইয়ার কস সি উইল বি ইয়োর বেস বাই হাইপোটেনাস, সো বেস ইজ ইয়ার বিসি, ফোর অ্যাঙ্গুল সি, ফোর অ্যাঙ্গুল সি, বেস ইজ ইয়োর বিসি, সো বিসি বাই এসি। দেন টেন সি ইজ দ্য পারপেন্ডিকুলার বাই বেস, দ্যাটস ওয়াই এবি বাই বিসি। দেন কসে উইল বি রিভার্স অফ সাইন সি অর অপোজিট অফ সাইন সি, দ্যাটস ওয়াই অপোজিট ওয়ান, হাইপোটেনাস বা পারপেন্ডিকুলার, লেটস ওয়াই এসি বাই পারপেন্ডিকুলার এবি। সেক্স ইজ হাইপোটেনাস বাই বেস, এসি বাই বিসি। দেন কট সি ইজ বেস বাই অপোজিট অফ টেন সি, সো যেগুলো বেস বাই, বেস বাই পারপেন্ডিকুলার, লেটস ওয়াই বেস বাই পারপেন্ডিকুলার, হিয়ার বেস ইজ ইয়োর বিসি অ্যান্ড ইয়োর পারপেন্ডিকুলার উইল ইয়োর এবি। ওকে, নাও অল অফ ইউ সি দ্য পেজ নাম্বার 178 অফ ইয়োর এনসিইআরটি বুক। সি দ্য পেজ নাম্বার 178 অফ ইয়োর এনসিইআরটি বুক। ওয়ান কোয়েশন ইজ গিভেন, রিড দ্য কোয়েশন অল অফ ইউ। সি দ্য পেজ নাম্বার 178 অফ ইয়োর এনসিইআরটি বুক, ওয়ান কোয়েশন ইজ গিভেন। ওকে, আই উইল রিড দ্য কোয়েশন। ইফ টেন এ ইকুয়াল টু 4/3, দেন ফাইন্ড দ্য আদার ট্রিকোনোমেট্রিক রেশিও অফ দ্য অ্যাঙ্গুল এ। নাও ওয়ান ট্রেঙ্গুল ইজ অলসো গিভেন ইন ইয়োর কোয়েশন, এবিসি, এট ওয়ান ট্রেঙ্গুল ইজ গিভেন এবিসি। আসি, ওকে, লেট মি ড্র ওয়ান ট্রেঙ্গুল ফার্স্ট, লেট মি ড্র ওয়ান ট্রেঙ্গুল ফার্স্ট। ওকে, নাও হিয়ার দিস ইজ এ ট্রাঙ্গল, ট্রাঙ্গল ইজ গিভেন ইন ইয়োর কোয়েশন। সাপোজ ইয়োর এ ট্রাঙ্গল ইজ গিভেন, এ বি সি, এ ট্রাঙ্গল ইজ গিভেন অ্যান্ড দ্য ইট ইজ গিভেন দ্যাট ইফ টেন এ ইকুয়াল টু হাউ মাচ, ইফ টেন এ ইকুয়াল টু 4/3, ইফ টেন এ ইকুয়াল টু 4/3, ইফ টেন এ ইকুয়াল টু 4/3, ইউ হ্যাভ টু ফাইন দ্য আদার ট্রিকোনোমেট্রিক রেশিও ফর দ্য অ্যাঙ্গুল। না সে ইয়ার আই হ্যাভ অলরেডি টোল্ড ইউ না, ফর দ্য অ্যাঙ্গুল এ ইয়ার ইউ আর আস্ক টু ফাইন দ্য ট্রিকোনোমেট্রিক রেশিও ফর দ্য অ্যাঙ্গুল এ। সো ইফ দ্য, ইফ ইউ আর আস্ক টু ফাইন্ড ফাইন্ড দ্য ট্রিকোনোমেট্রিক রেশিও ফর দ্য অ্যাঙ্গুল সি, ইউর অ্যান্সার উইল বি ডিফারেন্ট। না সি ইয়ার দিস ইজ রাইট অ্যাঙ্গুল ট্রাঙ্গল, ইট ইজ অলরেডি গিভেন ইন দ্য কোয়েশন, দ্য ফিগার ইজ অলরেডি গিভেন ইন দ্য কোয়েশন। So this is right angle triangle. So you have to find the all the trigonometric ratio for the angle A. For the angle A. Now see, for the angle A, which one will be your perpendicular? For the angle A, which one will be your perpendicular? Yes, your BC will be your perpendicular because BC is opposite to A. So BC will be your perpendicular. And for the angle A, which one will be your hypotenuse? Yes, because AC is opposite to angle B and angle B is 90 degree. So AC will be your hypotenuse. And the remaining side is AB. AB will be your base. Yes or no? So for the angle A, just remember this, that BC is your perpendicular, AB is your base and AC will be your hypotenuse. Now here 10A is given, 10A equal to 4/3. 10 you know, 10 means what? The ratio of perpendicular by base. That's now I have told you that the ratio of 10 is perpendicular by base, and here 10 is given. So in this triangle, which one will be perpendicular? The perpendicular will be BC, and your base will be your what? AB. Have you understood? Yes or no? Now see, 10A we know, 10A is perpendicular by base. We know that 10A is perpendicular by base. Just now we have discussed about this, no? The 10A, what is 10A, what is sine A, what is cos A. So 10A is perpendicular by base. So we have given 4 by 3. So here in this triangle, what is perpendicular? The perpendicular is your AC. So sorry, here the perpendicular is a BC, not AC. AC is the hypotenuse. Here the perpendicular is BC. This one is a perpendicular, no? That's why BC. And your base will be AB. So it's AB. That means 10A equal to 4 by 3 equal to, you can write BC by AB. Now see, this is the ratio. Suppose we already discussed in class 9 that suppose A is to A by B or A is to B equal to suppose 1 by 2. Then we can write A equal to, suppose we can take 1 by 2 equal to K, a arbitrary constant. So A will be then K and B will be 2K. Similar concept we have to apply here. Suppose this is equal to, suppose, so we can write like this now, BC by AB equal to 4 by 3. Yes or no? So we can write K, any arbitrary constant. So from here we can write BC equal to your 4K and AB will be your 3K. Now again we know Pythagoras theorem. I think in class 9 itself you have known the Pythagoras theorem. What is the Pythagoras theorem? For any right angle triangle, the Pythagoras theorem is your what? Perpendicular square plus base square equal to hypotenuse square. This is the Pythagoras theorem. Yes or no? Here the perpendicular in this triangle, what, which one is a perpendicular? That means BC will be your perpendicular, then AB is your base. So perpendicular square plus base square equal to hypotenuse square. So AC will be your hypotenuse square. Now we know the value of BC and AB. We have to find the AC. Just put the value. BC square will be, that means 4K whole square. Then AB square is 3K whole square equal to AC square. Now see here, 4AC square equal to 4K whole square means 16K square, and 3K whole square means 9K square. So AC square will be 16K square plus 9K square, it will be 25K square. So AC square is 25K square. So your AC will be root over 25K square. So it will be plus minus 5K. But we can't take the negative sign. Why? Because it is a side, and side cannot be negative. That's why we have to take the only the positive one. So that means AC will be your 5K. Now we have found the value of BC, we have found the value of AB, we have found the value of AC in terms of K. So we can find the ratio, other ratio, that means cos A, 10A, sorry, 10A is given. So cos A, sin A, cot A, cos A, K, sec A. So here, K is all, in all the value, K is present. So K and K, because since it is a ratio, so K and K will be cancel out, yes or no? Now see, I think Pythagoras, all of you know this theorem. Okay, now see, now we have to find the all the ratio. Now we have to find all the ratio. So 10A is given, so first we have to find the sin A. Now what is sin A? Let me first erase it. This is perpendicular. Now to find the sine A. we have to find sin a. So sin a will be your, we know what is the formula, what is the ratio of sin? Sin a is your, what is the ratio? That's now we have discussed. That means your perpendicular by hypotenuse. Yes, perpendicular by hypotenuse. Perpendicular by hypotenuse. So here perpendicular is your BC and hypotenuse is your AC. Just put the value here. BC is your 4K and your AC is your 5K. K and K will cancel out. So your answer will be 4 by 5. So sine A is 4 by 5. Then you have to find cos A. Cos A what is the ratio? Cos A, what is the ratio? Yes, base by hypotenuse. So your base is your AB. AB is your base. AB. And AC is your hypotenuse. So what is the value of AB here? AB is your 3K. What is the value of AC here? This is the value, yes or no? So 5K. So K and K will get cancelled out. So it will be 3 by 5. Sin A we have found, cos A we have found, then opposite of sin A will be your cos A K. Cos A K, just reverse it. It will be 5 by 4. Then opposite of cos A will be your sec A. Opposite of cos A will be your sec A. Opposite of cos A will be your sec A. So sec A will be the reverse it will be 5 by 3. And so we have found sin A, we have found cos A, we have found cos A K, we have found sec A. The remaining one is which one? Yes, cot A. Cot A is the opposite of tan A. So tan A, this is just reverse it. It will be tan A is given 4 by 3. So cot A will be 3 by 4. Okay. So like this, we can find the ratio of the given angle. Okay. Now all of you do one thing. See the page number 178, question number 2. Do as your homework. And if you any doubt, then ask me. Question number 2 is your homework. Then see page number 181. Then see the page number 181. In CRT 181, exercise 8.1. See the first question, same question. In a triangle ABC, right angle at AB will be, the value AB is given 24 centimeter, BC is given 7 centimeter. Your value of AB is given, you have to do the, you take this one as a homework. AB is given 24 centimeter, then your BC is given your 7 centimeter. You have to find sin A and cos A. And your, yes or no? So just see here. Here it is given ABC is a triangle right angle. See the question. ABC is a triangle right angle at B. That means B is 90 degree. So you have to draw one triangle and you have to take the right angle as B. You can take A here or here. No, this is not a problem. You can take right down here. A is A here also, A here also. So if you write A here, it will be C. Angle B is given. So if the value of AB is given, value of BC is given. So using Pythagoras theorem, you can find the value of BC. Then just put the value and find the ratio sine and cos. Okay. So do this one as a homework. First one is your page number 178, example 2, and exercise 8.1, page number 181, question number 1. Okay. So thank you.